soon.
The old toilet paper meme? Oh yeah. Yeah, we can I can do that. I haven't done that in a while. So the other day I was on Reddit. I was browsing and I came upon this old 9gag article that was linking to a Tumblr post that was reading on Twitter about Anita Sarkeesian, how she was tweeting about this thread where there was this dude who was talking about this family that apparently had heard of someone else, that they had this ritual of they went to the poo-poo, okay? But in the toilet, they didn't have normal toilet paper. It was really fucking confusing, okay? Because you would go to the toilet and be like, yo, I just took a shit. Where do I wipe? And you might think, oh, they're one of those green families. They have a bidet. Uh-uh. Nope. This is not a story about bidets, let me tell you that. The story revolves around the fact that the energy consumption of our paper manufacturers is so big that even during the layoffs of Blizzard Activision 2021, we still have to take into consideration that people shit, right? And you might look at India and go, well, yeah, they have dedicated shitting streets. Should we do that everywhere? And the answer obviously is no. Like, we can't just, even if Paris is trying it out and all the streets smell like shit, we can't just, the entire world just can't have dedicated shitting streets. As great as that would be. Anyway, so this man was frantically. This man was frantically in the toilet, searching for the answers. He went through all the drawers and everything, and he found nothing. He didn't find any toilet paper, so he was really ashamed of it. He was like, man, so I guess I can't wipe my ass now. And he was too afraid to ask his friend that maybe they had run out of toilet paper, right? Maybe the toilet paper just wasn't there. Maybe, you know, sometimes you run out of these things. So he sat there, you know, scratchy and itchy anus. And until he did actually manage to get the courage to ask the family, hey, Jimmy. Let's just call him Jimmy. Hey, Jimmy, do you happen to have a toilet paper? And they were like, yeah, it's there. It's that thing there. And he pointed at this rag. And it was really confusing because it was a rag. You know, the sort of thing you wipe your hands on, right? Like, he was like, surely that's, you know, you don't understand. I don't want to wash my hands. I want to clean my ass because I took a shit. And the problem with that was that the Jimmy was serious. Jimmy wasn't confused. Even though in Jim's family there had been some early onset Alzheimer's, which was the real tragedy when their grandpa, when their grandpa was actually, you know, driving a school bus and it drove down a cliff because of Alzheimer's. He thought he was still carrying prison labor stuff to somewhere else, and he was just, it's a long story, I don't want to get into it now. Anyway, so there's early onset Alzheimer's, so this person in question, let's call him Pete, was sure that Jimmy had a bit of the early onset Alzheimer's, because nobody would surely recommend wiping their entire butt on something that's not paper, right? Like, he was like, oh, he just means that maybe there's a bidet. Maybe there's a bidet behind the thing. Maybe there's, you know, it's hidden somewhere. So Pete closed the door. He was like, ah, okay, yeah, thanks. And Jimmy just walked off. And Jimmy actually left the apartment, right? And he was left there with Jimmy's mom. Yeah, this is a story. It's a story. Yeah, Jimmy was left there Pete was left there with Jimmy's mom, Barbara. And, Barbara had huge badonkadonks, right? But that's not, again, not the point of the story. Jimmy was in the toilet. No, Pete was in the toilet! And he was searching for the bidet still, and he was looking at it. He was just thinking, maybe I should just take my underwear, right? And just like, right? Maybe that's not too bad of an idea at this point, and just walk home without underwear. You know? Who's in the toilet? Pete! God damn it! Stop it! Pete is in the toilet. Jimmy left, okay? Jimmy left, and Pete is in the toilet. And there's Barbara in the kitchen, naked. But that's, again, it's because she came from the bathroom earlier because there was a bath. Anyway, it's called bathroom for a reason, not a toilet room. Anyway, so Pete's searching frantically. Pete's, who left? Jimmy! God, how do you guys listen to me? Fucking hell. Where does Jimmy Witchkin? Well, Pete thought that maybe Jimmy thought... Pete was thinking that maybe Jimmy didn't want to say that they ran out of toilet paper. So he maybe went to the shop to buy some toilet paper, right? And Pete was just confused. Maybe he just has to wait. What the fuck was that? Jimmy thought that Pete thought that Jimmy left. No, Pete's friend's mom, Barbara, has big booba. So you don't four joints in a row. Anyway. So Pete was just searching for the thing and then he found a sauna. Right, they had a sauna. Jim isn't the mom, no. Jim's mom, Barbara, and you know, like, Pete was thinking, no, Barbara took the shit earlier at the bathtub. But again, that's not part of this story, okay, Rigged? Stop trying to, you know, Barbara is currently naked in the living room kitchen area, making some hot donuts, which is really scary to do naked because the oil, well, Barbara's old name was Jim. But that's neither here or there because she's actually, you know, we can talk about this stuff, but she's trans, but it's fine. She's completely, you know, it's all good. Anyway, the fact of the matter is that Jim's mom's dad had died from a hunting incident because of the Alzheimer. I know I said earlier it was a bus accident, but it was actually a bus accident while hunting. So they were taking this full boss with like these bear carcasses and stuff, and they were just taking it on a ride, and there were like school children in there as well, but it was all good. And he just drove down a cliff, and he thought that he was like making it was like a downhill, but it turned out to be a cliff. And it's really scary because sometimes, you know, these sort of things can happen to anyone, to be honest. Like you think, you know, you're on an autopilot. I'm sure you guys have been on autopilot before, where you think that you're doing something, you wake up, right, and you go and make the No, we're gonna get back to that, Mitch. It was Pete. God damn it! Stay fucking tuned, okay? Pete was it, okay? So Jimmy's away, and Pete doesn't actually know where he's going. He thinks that he's going to buy the toilet paper. No, the bus didn't have a toilet because it was for bears only. Fucking idiots! Let me explain. Okay, so we have this situation where Barbara's dad is driving the bus, right? And unfortunately, with the situation, the bears were inside the bus. Okay, bears don't drive buses. Wait, did you have this underwear? No. It was, first of all, it was Pete, and Jim was contemplating it, but this was. Yes, not in the bus, but it's actually, you're kind of right, Graffin, because they actually redecorated in memory of Barbara's dad dying in the bus. They actually decorated the kitchen to be a bus area. You know how you can take like the decoration. So there was like a round table that's like it has like the lights and stuff, and yeah, they were just vibing. They were dead, but they might have been still high from the triangulizers because the gym's Barbara's dad. Steve didn't actually, you know, they didn't actually like killing animals that much. Donuts were decoration. Yes, they were decoration because nobody eats donuts in 2021 anymore, right? Although this happened in, was it 1938? But I can't remember. So, anyway, Pete was in the toilet thinking that, wow, maybe I should go and ask Barbara, even though... Yes, but it was a... He was related to the hunting accident! No, Steve's underwear wasn't... No, Steve's underwear wasn't in the fucking, you know... Oh, for fuck's sake, Steve's underwear wasn't in the sauna. It's gonna be... Oh my god. So, Pete goes into the sauna thinking maybe the toilet paper is there. Steve is Barbara's dad! Oh my god, I sometimes think you guys fucking don't listen to me at all. So, Steve's ashes are found in the sauna. It's not... He didn't die in the sauna. he's still in the bathroom. What the fuck? And welcome back to me. I mean, I can recap if you want. So we have the situation.
Seriously, dead many years. He died when he drove those bears down the fucking school bus. You guys, we need to make this so fucking clear, okay? I don't know why you guys are so stupid. Okay, you guys are so fucking stupid. Oh my god. I need to fucking... Oh my god.
Pete. In toilet. Okay? Jim. Gone. Barbara. Dad. Steve. Right? Okay. Are we fucking good? Can you read? There we go. Good. Okay. Wonderful. There we go. So, Pete is in the toilet, but he goes to the sauna where Steve's ashes are. And he was thinking maybe he can use the ashes to, like, you know how baby powder works, right? So you put baby powder, and when babies have diarrhea or something, you put the baby powder, and it's going to help them, like, the itching and stuff. But he didn't realize it's actually the ashes until he used them. Yeah, he used them, but it actually made it worse because of some of the chemical ingredients they use. Well, Steve is not a baby. Not anymore. No, he's very dead. Steve used to be a baby. In 1927, when he was born, he was a very cute baby. For some reason, he had a mustache when he was born already, and that was really weird. But that had nothing to do with the Alzheimer's and the bus incident. If Barbara is Dad and Daddy Steve, then Barbara is not Steve. Technically, no, Jim was not shitting. No, Barbara came from the toilet, but Jim has never shat in his life. He suffers from chronic constipation. Why does Barbara doesn't have a mustache? It's Steve. Okay, I'm just gonna, like, ignore these dumb questions. And yeah, it was a haunting. It was, because he was carrying. Okay, for fuck's sake, Steve had a haunting incident while driving under the influence of Alzheimer's, right? It's a haunting incident because he thought he was driving the school bus, and he was thinking that he had been carrying bears in it, but it was actually children, and they all went down a cliff. What is the speed of an unladen swallow? I have no idea. If Jim wasn't shitting, it was Barbara. No, Barbara took a shit earlier in the bathtub, but we haven't really... Yeah, so basically, the bears had been taken, and there's, like, these bear rugs. You guys are confusing the fuck out of me. Jesus Christ, I'm trying to tell this story. So Barbara is making the donuts, and as Steve doesn't know that Barbara's made the donuts, and he's trying to just sneak. So he has the ashes of Barbara's dad's. So Steve's ashes are inside his asshole right now, because he can't wipe them away with anything because there's no toilet paper, right? So he walks into the kitchen, and it's really awkward because actually Barbara is stuck in the donut machine. Yes, Pete is gay. So Barbara is stuck in the donut machine, and Barbara is like, oh no, I'm stuck, Steve, please help. Sorry, Pete, please help. And Pete couldn't do anything because he's gay. Anyway, he was going into the kitchen to find the... Hey, Cesar. Oh, fuck. Do I need to start again? Oh, jeez. Okay. I'm going to recap real quick in like 30 seconds for everybody who joined. So, Steve is in the... Pete is in the bathroom, okay? Pete is in the bathroom, and he is taking a shit at his friend's... Jim's... place, okay? No, this is a quick recap. Steve was always there in the sauna, but yeah, it's Pete who was in the bathroom, and Pete takes a shit, and then he can't find toilet paper anywhere. No, I can't start again. Steve's dead. Where did the mic? There's no mics yet. Mike Yama, the creator of GDQ, is there, but it's not. He's actually the stepdad, but we don't go there yet. Anyway, see, so we have... Fuck! We have Jim, Pete in the toilet. And Pete asks Jim, hey, could you give me toilet paper, please? And it's really fucked up because Jim's like, no, don't use that. He's pointing at a rug. Or like a, you know, like the thing you like clean your hands with. On the toilet. In the bathroom, on the toilet. Not anymore, because after when you're asking for Jim, you walk up from the toilet. Anyway, So he's asking for Jim, hey, do you guys have any toilet paper? Because I think you guys ran out. And he did like this nervous laughter, like, ha, 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 ha. And because he did that nervous laughter, Jim was a bit unsure. No, Barbara is not a man. No, stop asking these fucking dumb questions. Listen to me for like a second. If it was Steve at this point, we just mash and just wash them. It's Pete! Steve is fucking dead! Yeah, thank you. Jesus Christ, thanks for realizing a mistake. Oh, so, anyway, Barbara is not stuck in the bathroom. Barbara is stuck in the donut machine, but that's like 5 minutes from here, okay? Anyway, so, Steve, Pete, Pete, I have to look at the fucking thing. Pete is stuck in the bathroom while Jim leaves. He has the click, click, right? And Jim is gone while Pete is looking frantically in the toilet. And looking through all the closets and drawers and shit, and it's like, oh no, where can I find any toilet paper? No, Pete didn't know. Dad, I think you died. Steve died from Alzheimer's. Pete is in the toilet. Why is Pete stuck in the bathroom? Just find Steve stuck. What? No, that's not true. Okay, so TLDR, Jim. Oh my God, Pete is stuck. We don't know where Jim is yet. Jim left, and then Pete thinks that Jim is getting... Jim is getting... No, Pete hasn't died in the toilet. Nobody's died in the toilet yet, technically. I mean, we don't know about it yet, but, like, there might have been death. Steve is stuck in Pete's... Yes, thank you. So that's where we're at now. Jim is gone. Pete is in the toilet trying to find toilet paper. And Steve is inside his butthole because he's the ashes, because he died from the hunting incident while under the influence of Alzheimer's when driving bears in a school bus down the hill and just fucking it just exploded. So they just took the ashes there, right? because they didn't have a body. So, then, no, Jim, Pete thinks Jim got out to get the toilet paper. He didn't, but Steve couldn't know this because, Steve couldn't know this because he's fucking dead. Pete couldn't know this because he... fuck. Pete couldn't know this because he doesn't have a smartphone because it ran out of charge. And it's also 1987. So, Pete goes out. He has his pants down. And there's Barbara in the donut machine stuck. But because Pete's gay, he can't do anything about it. 1986, 1987, that could be the year, yes. He goes into the kitchen, asks Barbara, yo, Barbara, do you guys have any toilet paper? And she starts crying, not again. Don't ask about it. And he gets really confused. And Barbara just shuts down completely. Her hands are inside the donut machine like this, tits just hanging out. She's naked because she just came from the bathtub having a shit. No, she's not. No, 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 no. Barbara is solo right now. Single. Technically. Like, not married. Either way. Fucking... Pete starts going through the kitchen drawers, and he just finds donut powder after donut... Yeah, she took... Yes, because they don't have... See, this is where it all comes in. She took a shit in the bathtub so she can clean herself. She can clean herself there. In the bathtub. That's the meta here. Because Jim is a believer of the reusable toilet paper, right? Barbara is an old school person. She doesn't like that. Plus, females, when they do the whole... When they, like, wash the genitals and stuff, you gotta be more careful than us dudes. Because we can just, like, do whatever we want, except use old dudes' ashes to clean it, because that's just nasty. I'm dead. Jim is not dead. Jim is just gone. It's fine. As females wash their genitals. From front to back. Front to back, right? Don't wash back to front. Because the thing with the reusable toilet papers is that if you use them from back to front, they explode. Because all the germs and stuff are just going to get into vagina. Not good, right? For males, it doesn't matter. Usually go from left to right. But sometimes people go right to left if they're feeling really juicy. Some people go inside to out. Outside to in is kind of hard. Because it kind of leaves the tissue there. But anyway. Netflix would buy this story. It's actually I tried marketing it to them. There's some details that are still slightly missing. Anyway, Jim comes back, and when he comes back through the door, Barbara is stuck in the donut machine, right? Pete is in the kitchen naked, and Jim gets fucking shocked. Jim is like, how can you do this? And Jim is like, I promise I wasn't fucking your mom, okay? But with him, with Jim, he has another Pete. There's two Petes in the apartment. And the Pete goes into the bathtub. No, sorry, the bathroom, which doesn't have the bathtub. They have a different room for it. And he goes there and says, hey, I need you to take a shit. And it's really confusing because in that moment, you realize that there's two of them. And Barbara actually fucking comes out screaming from the donut machine and stabs Pete in the spleen. And right that moment, you forget all about the toilet paper. Jim starts crying, saying that you should have just used... You should have fucking used the toilet paper. You should have used it. And Pete starts crying with his last breaths that he didn't know where the toilet paper is. And Jim's just crying that he pointed you at it. Yes. He pointed you at it. While... Then we hear... Then while we're being stabbed... Well, not we. While Pete is being stabbed in the kitchen floor into the spleen and he's crying out, the call 911. No, I'm not copying Twilight. This is a story that I heard from a friend. Yes, we are taking the actions of Pete here. So Pete is being stabbed in the spleen in the kitchen, and we hear the other Pete, the Pete 2, if you will, yelling from the bathroom, "Yo, Jim, you got any toilet paper?" And that's how you know that we're fucked. But all of this could have been easily avoided if we just used the reusable so there's this family, they used reusable toilet paper. So they had these little squares that they would use, and they would wash them instead of like using toilet paper, because that's really wasteful. So they would just they would take these little squares and they would wash them. Not yet reality. No, that's in the sequel. Well, I didn't hear how it ends, because actually the person who told me this was Steve, just on his deathbed. I was a friend of his. Anyway, so the family, like, for some reason there's like these people who instead of like toilet paper, imagine going to your friend's house and asking, hey, where's your toilet paper? They would give you these small squares, right? And they would be like, yeah, use this. And then you would put them in the bin. And you would put them in the bin. And they would, like, wash them. Instead of, like, reuse them, right? How disgusting is that? Yeah, that'd be fucked up. That's so kind of fucked up. Like, I appreciate on this stuff like that. Like, I read a thread that where people use reusable toilet paper, they still have, like, normal toilet paper for, like, friends and family who are visiting. That is real. Google reusable toilet paper. Reusable toilet paper. Oh, finally. Fuck yeah. Anyway. So that's the story of how people use that. Any questions? I didn't understand what's so... this always happens when I'm telling the story. People get fucking confused, even though, like, the details are all there.